In this class, let's see about ideal and non-ideal solutions. First, about the ideal solution. What is this? An ideal solution is the solution which obeys Rogge's law at all concentrations and temperatures. Which obeys Rogge's law at all temperatures and concentrations. All temperatures and concentrations. That is ideal solution. So here we discussed about the solutions of liquid mixture. That means solute is liquid, solvent is liquid. So here we discuss, we mainly focus on liquid mixtures. Both solute and solvent are liquids. In that first ideal solution. Ideal solution means which obeys Rogge's law at all temperatures and concentrations. What are the conditions to make an ideal solution? Let's see one by one. An ideal solution is formed by compounds having similar sizes and structures. Similar sizes and structures. Compounds which have similar sizes and structures form ideal solution. Let's see the conditions for ideal solutions. To form an ideal solution, the two components in the ideal solution must have similar sizes and structures. Second one, they must have, suppose if we consider solute A and solvent B, or solvent A or solute B. Let us consider two components, A and B. Okay. Then, AA interaction, BB interaction, and AB interactions are same. AA interaction. Let A be the solvent, B be the solute. So, AA interaction, BB interaction, AB interaction is same. That means to break bond between A is same as that of B, and to form bond, some energy is released. In bond breaking, energy is required. In bond formation, energy is released. Here, AA, BB, AB interaction is same means to break bond AA, bond BB, bond between AB similar. That means bond required for AA, BB is same as energy released in AB. Next point. So here in ideal solution, interactions and all the particles are same. Third condition is PA is equal to P0A XA as per Rogge's law. Partial pressure of a component in the mixture is equal to the product of these two. Similarly, PB equals to P0BXB. In the same way, P total is equal to PA plus PB. That means P0AXA plus P0BXB. P0AXA plus P0BXB. So these are the conditions for ideal solution. Next, one more point is, let's see the thermodynamic parameters about ideal solution. For ideal solution, you know, delta G mix or delta C in the delta H mix first. Delta mix, which means enthalpy of mixing. Enthalpy of mixing. Delta mix, it is denoted by delta mix H. This is called what? Enthalpy of mixing. For the formation of an ideal solution, its value is 0. Why enthalpy of mixing is 0 for an ideal solution? Because interactions between solvent-solvent, solute-solute, and fluid solid or same. That's why no energy is released for an ideal solution. Enthalpy of mixing is zero. Enthalpy of mixing means delta H, already you know that when a reaction takes place, there may be some energy released or absorbed, or in some reactions, no energy is released, no energy is absorbed. If delta H is negative, that is exothermic, energy is released. If delta H is positive, that is endothermic, that means energy is absorbed. If delta H is zero, that indicates what? No energy is released, no energy is absorbed. Why? In the formation of a ideal solution, why there is the enthalpy of mixing zero? Earlier I said that interactions among all the particles is the same. That means the energy required to break this bond, AA bond, BB bond, are same. That's why the formation of AB energy released is also same. That means energy required to break this bond and this bond is equal to energy released in the formation of this bond. So that's why number of energy required to break bonds is equal to energy released in the formation of bonds. That is the reason why enthalpy of mixing is zero. Similarly, volume of mixing denoted by delta mix V, it is also zero. Enthalpy of mixing is zero. In the same way, volume of mixing is zero. It indicates what? Here, see, if you mix 5 ml of A, 5 ml of B, 5 ml of A plus 5 ml of B is equal to 10 ml of A. You are mixing 5 ml A, 5 ml B, you are getting 10 ml of A. That means here after mixing also there is no change in the volume. That's why volume of mixing is zero. Why it is zero? Again, we use the same concept that energy to break AA, BB, energy required to break AA and BB is same as that released in the formation of AB. Interactions are same. That's why there will be no change in the volume of mixture. Similarly, next point, you know, the components of an ideal solution can be separated by fractional distillation. Components can be separated by fractional distillation. What is this? Fractional distillation. What is fractional distillation? Yes. Here, if two liquid components are there with different boiling points, using distillation process, we separate both the components. If boiling points difference is very high, we use normal distillation process. If boiling points of both the liquids are similar, then we use fractional distillation. In the fractionated distillation, we use a fractionating column, which allows only less boiling point vapors, liquid with lesser boiling point vapors. So, liquid with low boiling point escapes out through the fractionating column, whereas liquid with the higher boiling point remains in the distillation flask. So, in that way, vapors of the distillation are nothing but more volatile component. Next, the residue left in the flask is less volatile component. Less volatile component means more boiling point. More volatile component means lesser boiling point. In that way, we can separate the components of an ideal solution by using this fractional distillation. Let's see some examples for these ideal solutions. You know, ideal solution, 100% ideal solution cannot be prepared. They do not exist. No solution is 100% ideal. idea. But we can prepare solutions with nearly ideality. That means solutions may act as nearly ideal solution, but not 100% ideal solution. So that's why see some mixtures which can act as nearly ideal solutions. So already I said that which type of compounds form ideal solution? Compounds having similar sizes and structures can form ideal solution. That's why see examples. First one, N hexane plus N hectane, both are alkenes. N hexane, N heptane are alkenes. So their mixture act as nearly ideal solution. Similarly, benzene and toluene. What is the form of benzene? C6H6+. Toluene C6H5CH3. Benzene toluene mixture also acts as nearly ideal solution. Third one, ethyl chloride and ethyl bromide. C2H5Cl plus C2H5Br. C2H5Cl plus C2H5Br. Similarly, vinyl chloride CH2 double bond CHCl plus vinyl chloride. Similarly, vinyl bromide CH2 double bond CHBr. So these are different examples for ideal solutions. Different examples for ideal solutions. See, have you looked on the properties of ideal solutions? These are all. See, some more properties related to ideal solutions. What about their delta G and delta S? For ideal solutions, delta G, that means delta mix G. What is delta G? It is change in Gibbs energy. Delta G means change in Gibbs energy. After mixing the component A and B, how is the change in Gibbs energy? So for that there is a formula that 2.303 N total into RT into sigma xi log xi. This is the formula. For the delta G mix, this is the formula. Here, sigma xi log xi indicates what? Xi is the mole fraction of eighth component. That means if an ideal solution contains only two components, so here we write x1 log x1 plus x2 log x2. If the solution contains three components, then x1 log x1 plus x2 log x2 plus x3 log x3. Here we are discussing about binary liquid mixture. That's why we can write this formula as 2.303 N total into RT into XA log XA plus XB log XB. This is the formula for the binary mixture. Okay, here see the terms N total means total number of moles in that ideal solution. That means number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. R is gas constant. T is absolute temperature. XA, it is mole fraction of component A. XB, it is mole fraction of component B. So this is delta G mix. Is it negative or positive? See, you know, mole fraction is always less than 1. Mole fraction is always less than 1. That's why log of log XA becomes negative. Log 1 is 0. Log of value less than 1 means negative. That means for ideal solution, delta G mix is negative. Okay. See, for delta mix S, what is this? This is entropy of mixing. This is entropy mixing. It is entropy of mixing. It is Gibbs energy of mixing. G means Gibbs energy or Gibbs function. S means entropy. Entropy of mixing, Gibbs function of mixing or Gibbs energy of mixing. So its value is -2.303 N total into R into sigma xi log xi. This is the formula. So if you apply this equation for the binary liquid mixture, then it becomes -2.303 N total into R into to here xa log xa plus xb log xb. This is the formula. Okay, see here already negative sign. Xa mole fraction of any component is less than 1. That's why log of mole fraction gives a negative value. Negative value already there is negative. Negative into negative becomes positive. That's why entropy of mixing is positive for an ideal solution. Whereas delta G mixing, the delta G of mixing is a negative. Delta G negative means spontaneous process. Delta G negative means spontaneous. Similarly, delta G positive means non-spontaneous. Do you know what is spontaneous and non-spontaneous process? Spontaneous process means a process or a reaction which occurs on its own is called spontaneous. So, see some examples. Water flows from higher level to lower level. It is spontaneous. No external agents is required there. But water only flows from lower to higher level using some external agents like motor. When we use motor, then only water is lifted to higher level. That means there we used an external agent that is non-spontaneous. Similarly, gas flows from high pressure to low pressure region, spontaneous. So, for spontaneous process, delta G is always negative. So, these are all the parameters for ideal solution. Let's see the graph related to ideal solution. So, this is the graph drawn between vapor pressure versus mole fraction. Here, mole fraction of A, component A is 1. Then, mole fraction of B is 0. Similarly, when we go from left to right, what happens is mole fraction of A decreases and delta mole fraction of B increases. So here xA equal to 0, xB equal to 1. So here at this point there is no component of B. That's why let it be the vapor pressure of this is P0A. Why it is P0A? Here only component A is present in the mixture. That's why no B. That's why the pressure exerted by two solvents is called what? P0A. Similarly, this side there is only B, no A. So at this point P0B. So this is P0A, there is P0B. Okay, so by seeing this graph, can you say which is more volatile liquid? A or B? Which is more volatile? Yes, B is the more volatile liquid. Why? Then A, at constant temperature, then A, B is having high vapor pressure. Let's see the graph related to ideal solutions. Here, at this end, only component A is present. At this end, only B is present. We are taking this A and B in different proportions. Initially, 1 plus 0. After, in the second sample, 0.9, 0.1. In the third sample, 0.8, 0.2. In the fourth sample, 0.7, 0.2. In that way, if you continue it at the other end, it will be only B. Okay? So here, only 2A, that's why only 2B. So here pressure is due to only component B. Here pressure is due to only component B. So pure component means P0A, this side, P0B, that side. Okay. So when the composition of XA, when the composition of A in the mixture decreases, what happens? Pressure due to A also decreases. It will form a straight line. Like this. Similarly, from left to right, there is an increase in the composition of B. That's why its pressure increases. So, first line is of PA. This is PA. PA means partial pressure of A. This is PB, partial pressure of B. PA, AB. See the trend in A and B. There is increase in the concentration of A from left to right. That's why pressure due to A is decreasing. Similarly, from left to right, what is happening? Composition, that means the mole fraction of B is increasing. So there is increase in the pressure of B. At any point, how to calculate total pressure? So this dotted line indicates the total pressure of the mixture. That means P total it is. P total means PA plus PB. PA plus PB. That means at any point in the composition, say some point Z here. This is the point Z. At this point Z, let this value be some Px. This value be some Vz. Okay. So at the point Z, what is total pressure P? Total pressure P means PA plus PB. At Z, this is PB. This value is P. From 0 to PZ, this value, this total value is what? This is total pressure. How to get this PZ? Here PZ is equal to, it is PX, let it be some PY. So PZ is equal to PX plus PY. That means at any point in the curve, we can sum up the partial pressures of A and B to get the total pressure. Similarly, so this is the ideal behavior line, ideal solution line. This is PA. Similarly, this is PB. Already I wrote here. So this is the line of component A, partial pressure line of. This is the partial pressure line of component B. So decreasing trend, increasing trend. Okay, right. See here what is happening in total pressure, how to get total pressure. At any point, that means at any composition, total pressure is equal to sum of partial pressure of A and B. Okay, right. So total pressure, how does it vary the composition of A and B? Check it once. Here which is more volatile between A and B, which is more volatile? B. So when there is increase in the concentration of B in the liquid mixture, total pressure increases. See, there is upward trend. Why there is upward trend? Because B is more volatile. So when you increase the concentration of B in the mixture, then total pressure increases. What happens when A is increased? So further see, A is less volatile compound. That's why in the mixture, if we go from right to left, what happens? There from the left, right to left, A is increasing. A being less volatile, total pressure decreases. This is the trend. So when you move from right to left, there is decrease in the total pressure. Right to left means there is increase in the concentration of A. So in a liquid mixture, when increase the concentration of more volatile component, that means B, total pressure increases. In the same way, when increase the concentration of less volatile component, that means A, total pressure decreases. So in that way, total pressure of the liquid mixture depends on the composition of A and B. Okay? So this is the graph related to ideal solutions.